Good morning.
Good morning.
Today we will start laws of crystallography. The first law is law of rational indices. Also known as Boyle's law. And to explain this law, let us consider the three axes. These are Cartesian coordinates. X-axis, y-axis and z, and ABC plane, a unit plane. Just take an example, it cut x-axis at A, y-axis at B and z-axis at C. So this A, B, ABC is a plane which cut x-axis at A point, y-axis at B point and z-axis at C point, and this is origin. And OA is equal to small a, OB equal to small b, and OC equal to C. These are unit distance, the smallest possible plane, that is called unit plane, and unit plane is taken as ABC. Now if any plane if cut at 2A or B by 2 C, that is acceptable. Any plane can cut these axes multiple of either integer multiple or sub-integral multiple of A, B and C. That plane is acceptable. That means for this plane A, B, C are units, the multiple of A is 2, multiple of B is 1 by 2 and multiple of C is 1. So these are known as Weyl's indices. Multiple of A, B, C are known as Weyl's indices. Clear? But if we have a plane which cannot cut any of the axis, like a plane which cannot cut y-axis, for example, this is one of the plane, it cannot cut y-axis, it cut x-axis and z-axis. So any plane which cannot cut a particular axis, then intercept for that axis is taken as infinity. Means it cannot cut y, that means for y its intercept is taken as infinity. Clear? These are the 2a, b by 2, c. These are the intercepts. Clear? If it cannot cut any of the axes, the plane, then its intercept is taken as infinity. Okay? For that, let us take this is same as OC. Let us take it is A by 2. This is
2A, sir.
Let's take example. This is total A up to this. Right? Then half of it is
A by 2.
Okay. It is supposition, simple. I take it as A by 2. Okay? And this is taken as C. And what about this? Infinity. That means it intercept A by 2, then infinity, infinite B and C. That means Weyl's indices are 1 by 2, infinity and 1. That means now Weyl's indices cannot be defined for this particular plane. Because infinity comes into the picture. And you know, infinity means that cannot be defined. Then we take into account Miller indices. These are known as Weyl indices. But Weyl indices are applicable only if the plane cut all the axes. If the plane cut all the axes at any point. If it is parallel to any axis, if plane is parallel to any one of axes, but cannot cut a particular axis, then for that Weyl indices is taken as infinity. That means Weyl indices cannot be defined for that plane. So we take into account Miller indices. That means Miller indices is more authentic than Weyl indices. And for Miller indices, it can never be infinite or sub-integer. Miller indices can never be sub-integer or infinite. Means it cannot be fractional. And to find out Miller indices, the formula is, first we find an intercept. Intercept means multiple of ABC. Then second step is reciprocal of intercept, and third is multiply with smallest number to make them integer. These are the three steps. First we find out the intercepts of the plane, then we reciprocate the intercepts, and last is multiply with smallest number to make them integer. These are the steps. For example, for this plane 2a, b by 2 and c, this is the plane. Now its intercepts are 2, the Weyl indices are 2, 1 by 2 and 1. So 2, 1 by 2 and 1. Now reciprocate, 1 by 2, 2, 1. Then multiply it by smallest number to make them integer. Multiply it by 2. We multiply by a number which make it integer. Now it is fractional. If we multiply it by 1 by 2, it becomes 1 by 4. We have to make it integer. Clear? So it is 1 by 2 into 2. That is 1. 4. 2. That means Miller indices are 1, 4, 2. Miller indices for that particular plane is 1, 4, 2. And that is denoted by HKN. If H is 1, K is 4, and L is 2. What about this? What is Miller indices for this plane? These are Weyl indices. Now reciprocate, it become 2. This is first step. Now second step, 2, 1 by infinity, 0, 1. No need to multiply next because they are already integer. So it is 2, 0, 1. So Miller indices for this particular plane is 2, 0, 1. Now for Miller indices calculation, I denote it by MI. For Miller indices calculation, origin can never lie on the plane. Or we can say origin cannot pass through the plane. Or let us take an example. This is the plane we take into account. So we cannot take it as origin. Right? Origin should be outside the plane. Origin should be outside the plane. It cannot lie on the plane. Clear? Suppose this is the plane. We cut this into two equal halves. Okay? Diagonally. This is diagonal plane. Now we cut it. Then on these points, we cannot take origin. Origin should be outside. Origin should be outside the plane. For example, this is cubic crystal. This is y-axis, x-axis, and z-axis. Let us suppose this is the origin. Now, origin is, this is the front face, this one is front face, and what about this? This is back face, this is back face, and this one is front. Okay, now I take into account this front face, this is front face. Now, what are the intercepts for front face? This front face cannot cut y-axis. It will not cut z-axis. It will cut only x-axis. That means, for this is the origin. Origin is behind. Okay? So, this origin cannot lie on the plane. That way it's okay to keep it as origin. Okay? And it cut only x-axis. And unit cell length is, take it as A, O, A, O, B, and O, C, A, B, C. So that means for x-axis, it's intercept is A, and for y-axis, infinity. For y-axis, it is infinity, and for z-axis, it is also infinity. So what are ways in this is?
One, infinity.
Now, Miller indices, just reciprocate. If we reciprocate, it will become 1, 0, 0. No need for the next, because it is not fractional. So that means this is 1, 0, 0 plane. And this plane shows its direction. Plane indicates its direction. Because it cut x-axis only. That means it is on the x-axis. Okay? It is parallel to y and z-axis. Got it? If Miller indices are given, we can predict the direction of the plane. So this plane cut only y-axis. It is parallel to x and z-axis. Right? So that means it is infinity A. One B and infinity. So ways indices are ways indices infinity one infinity. So Miller indices are 0, 1, 0. What about this plane? It cut only z-axis. That means with respect to x, it is infinite. With respect to y again, infinite and c. So ways in this are infinity, infinity, 1. So what are Miller indices?
0, 0.
Okay, this is the plane. know what are the ways and indices for this. This is the origin. From the origin, from O to C. This is OC. It is C by 2. And it cannot cut X and Y axis. That means it is infinite A. Infinite A and infinite B half of C. Right? So infinite range indices are infinite and half. Then reciprocate it becomes 0. 0, 0, 0, 0, 2. So that means directly we get Miller indices. So 0, 0, 2 is a Miller indices for this particular plane. Because it cut only z axis at half of the unit cell. What about this?
B by 2.
It cut y axis at half of the distance and cannot cut x and z axis. That means with respect to x it is infinite, with respect to y it is b by 2, and with respect to c y z axis it is infinite c.
Infinite
1 by 2, infinite. These are range indices which cannot be defined for the plane. So we convert it into Miller indices. So Miller indices are
0,
2, 6. Now this plane cut only x axis. Clear? So it is A by 2. Infinite B, infinite C. That is, ways indices are 1 by 2, infinity, infinity. So, Miller indices are 2, 0, 0. Okay. This is the plane. So, what are the intercepts? See, this is the origin. The region it cut y axis and z axis at the unit cell length.
So
B akho, B akho, and C also akho. And the x axis it is parallel to x axis. It cannot touch x axis. Cannot cut x axis. It cut y axis. And z axis at unit cell length. Unit length. That means for x it is infinite. It is infinite A and B and
C.
That means ways and indices are infinity 1, 1. So Miller indices are 0, 1, 1. This is the plane. Intercepts. So that means ways and indices are 1, 1, 1. So Miller indices are same. So Miller indices are also 1, 1. Intercepts are x axis A by 2, B by 2, C by 2. That means for ways and indices 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 2. And Miller indices are 2, 2,